Welcome back to the 16 Mile Complex. I've got the legendary Ron McLean here with me in the future host arena of Rogers Hometown Hockey. Now, I gotta know, you're filming four seasons, 24 stops each. How's it gonna feel and how special will it be to come back to the city that you actually live in?
Well, you know, I had a bit of an experience like that, Kelsey, when in year one we did Red Deer, Alberta, where I grew up. So I moved to Oakville 32 years ago, certainly lived here a lot longer than Red Deer. But that was a special one because you knew so many stories. It was fun. We were out shooting some video digital links because we can't get everything on the telecast. So I put five stories together that will run on our web and on Instagram, Facebook, etc. And it was just neat to be able to turn left, turn right, know where you're going, and see someone you know at every turn.
Not have to rely on those darn GPSs. We've all seen that Office episode, right?
That's right. I had no GPS and I had no trouble running into the people I knew at Oakville Hockey Academy, where I used to play hockey with a guy named Jamie Allison, played in the National Hockey League. He wasn't there, but the guy who was out instructing at the academy is a guy named Mark Pendleton, whose wife plays hockey with my wife, Carrie. So that's how it goes in a small town.
That's so funny. And talking about those small towns, what do you think, out of all those stops that you've done across the country, east to west coast, what's the most hardcore hockey town in your opinion?
Oh, that's a tricky one. You know, I'll go by the towns that surprised me the most, Kelsey, were Grand Falls, Windsor, Newfoundland, which for me was a three-flight trip. I had to fly Toronto to Halifax, Halifax to St. John's, Newfoundland, St. John's to Gander, and then drive 90 minutes. And I thought, good grief, there can't be any hockey there. But it turned out that team won the Allan Cup last year, and the first NHLer in Newfoundland came from there, and on it went. So I always fondly recall the surprise of Grand Falls, and even last week in St. Thomas. Again, I kind of scratched my head thinking, what the heck are we going to talk about in St. Thomas? And lo and behold, we could have had 40 shows out of St. Thomas. The hockey tapestry was so rich.
That's so funny. Okay, now we got to wrap up quickly, but I have to know. In Coach's Corner, we always see those puns to end. I got to know, are those planned or a spur of the moment?
They are, I would say they're planned because I know what Don's going to talk about. But Don is the kind, you know, I'll say, you wanted to talk about Gordie Howe. He says, yes, I was going to talk about Gordie Howe, but I saw something this afternoon in the Boston game. I'll save Gordie for next week. And I think, rats, there goes my pun. So we'll see, Kelsey.
That's hilarious. Should we end tonight's on a pun?
Yeah, we can. Absolutely. I think we got to run, so we're Blades runners. How's that?
Do you guys like that one? Yeah? Okay, very, very lastly, what are the details of this weekend? I know you guys are all around Oakville. When, where?
Big
where can
festival.
People come out?
Both days, downtown Church Street. We are set up. Tara Sloan's doing a hot stove on the Saturday to kickstart things with Darcy Tucker, Adam Graves, and then there's live music, tons of stuff for the kids all day. Sunday, our broadcast is 1:30 local time. Great local stories. Harrison Brown is the first pro transgender athlete, plays for New York, and Tara did an amazing sit-down interview with Harrison Brown. Used to trick-or-treat at my door. Amazing. So we've got that. We've got Vic Hatfield, Paul Henderson, Adam Graves. We've got my wife, Carrie, a great story on her being saved 5 years ago by an ER doctor. So I hope folks can come out, and I hope if you can't come out, you can watch on Sportsnet.
All right, guys, a super special edition of Hometown Hockey tomorrow here in Oakville. For now, we'll send it back up to the guys, Jim and Al.